Hey everyone, today we're going to learn about a new feature that was recently released inside of Articulate Rise that allows you to build smaller micro-learning courses. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, welcome back. If you haven't checked out my website, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts with various different videos on learning development. You can also download templates, free templates, Articulate Storyline templates, XAPI templates as well. And then if any of these topics are new to you, you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z with Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, like we're talking about today, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. Now, Articulate Rise is an awesome tool. It makes it easy to build these different types of long scrolling pages and different types of interactions without having to be a developer. But this new feature allows you to build courses that are similar, but they're a little bit different. And that's why I wanted to explore that in this video. Let's go ahead and dive into Rise here. And I'm going to create a new project. Now, these are existing projects that I've used for past courses and other things like that. But I'm going to go ahead and go in and create a new course. Now, this is the new feature that is available. We can create a micro learning course. Just so we understand the difference here, if I go into one of my existing courses that is not a micro learning course here, you'll notice that I can create different pages and different an overview and everything like that. And then inside of these different pages, I can add different content. So it's a full course with different pages. It's a different content. It could be a pretty extensive course inside of Rise. Well, micro learning is a little bit different. Think of it as one page. So essentially you can build blocks inside of that page, but it's essentially just one page. However, the way that it displays the content is different. So we'll talk about that. So I'm gonna come into Create New, and then I'm gonna go into the micro learning section. This is one of the nice things about Articulate Rise is the fact that you can start from a template. They have so many different templates with actual content in there that you can start and use from that and just publish out to your LMS. Free content to be able to have users be able to explore and take that content. But I'm gonna go ahead and create a blank micro learning. We're gonna start from scratch here. So it's now gonna bring me right to a page. So no having to create the different pages inside of the menu or worry about that. It basically just takes me right to the first page with a title block here. We're gonna call this one Cooking 101. I always use that example. I don't know why, because I can't cook. But we're just gonna say cooking 101. Before we can adjust the theme, notice that I need to add a block before I can start adjusting the theme. And the theme is where I actually change the image. So we'll come back to that. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a text block. Let's just do a simple text block. And really that's what Rise is all about. It's about the different blocks that stack up on each other. And those blocks have different templates and different things that you can do. Some of them are flexible, some of them are not. That's one of the kind of drawbacks of Rise, is it's not as flexible as like Storyline, but you can insert different Storyline interactions inside of Rise as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on text, and now it's gonna show up with my text here. So I'm just gonna say prepping your food. And I'm not gonna worry about the text here. We're just gonna leave that blank for now. Let's add an image for our second one here. I'm gonna click on edit here, and I'm gonna click on edits over here. Now I'm gonna replace that image with the content library. You can go to pexels.com, you can go to unsplash.com to find different stock images, or content library has a lot of different images that you can use as part of your subscription as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and say cooking, whatever subject that you're looking for. And I'm gonna find one that kind of fits here. Let me select that one. And then I can adjust how this image is displayed. Do I want to click to enlarge? Do I want padding on top? Do I want padding on the bottom? Let's go ahead and get rid of the padding in this example here. And then I could also even change the position of the image. Do I want it to be the full width? I can have it be the full width there as well. So you can adjust those images right here. You can have the text on image. So there's a lot of different options to choose from here. But let's just keep it like that for now. Now we're gonna add one more block. We're gonna add a flashcards down at the bottom. So what we've done so far is not very different from what we've already done inside of Rise. If you've used Rise at all, it's pretty much the same. Where it differs is when you start to preview it. But before we do that, let's go ahead and change that initial image on top here, just so it has a cooking theme here. Now I'm gonna go into the theme. Now you can change the theme. There are different themes that you can choose from. There's about three of them for the microlearning courses, but I'm gonna go into the cover page and I'm gonna change this image right here. We're gonna replace the image from the content library and I'm gonna use cooking still as my search. And then I'm gonna go ahead and select this image here. Now it kind of darkens out the background once this gets loaded. So it darkens out the background, which is great because then it makes my text visible. So I can go back here. Now you can also change the colors to match more of your company colors. You can add custom colors as well. You can change the fonts. Now eventually you'll be able to like adjust the corners and paddings, custom paddings for your different blocks. That's all that I want to do for the theme so far. So let's go ahead and go back here. Now this is where it differs from Rise. So the way that it will display, and I'll show you how to actually even change it. There's two different options, but the way that it will display is each of the blocks will actually be almost like a separate page. So you can see here, we have this big full screen. And even if I was on like a phone, it takes up that full screen and so forth. But let's go back to the desktop here. And we have this arrow down at the bottom. Now, if you were on a mobile device, you could actually just swipe down or swipe up either way to like navigate through the course. But what's different is the navigation. The text area that I have fills up the entire window. So it takes you on those blocks section by section. So if I had a text box, it'll just focus on the text box. If I have an image like on the next page here, it will just focus on the image. So this is probably where I'd want to add some text over the image. Otherwise, I'd probably want to prompt them to say, hey, you're going to look at an image in the next section. It's one page, but those each of those sections in that page basically become their own section when you go in and you navigate through the course. You also have this indicator bar on the right hand side that allows you to jump to the different sections as well. So I'm going to jump to this flashcard and the flashcard takes up the full screen as well. Now there's a couple things that I can do as well to make this and adjust the style of this as well. So I'm going to go into this food prep area and let's change the background color. I'm going to go into the settings and I want to have this be a nice kind of blue color in the background. Let's use that color right there. And I'm going to adjust the font color as well. Select the fonts, come into the color, and let's go ahead and adjust that to white. So adjust the color, adjusting that to white there. And there we go. So that way, when I actually preview this, it's the whole block that becomes that blue and it kind of stands out a little bit more. I like the style of that. You can change that just on that one block and it will fill the entire page when it comes to this section. So that's one thing you can do. Let's say I wanted to add some more, like an image on top of this or something. I'm gonna click on edit. We're going to add a new block on top of that. And we're gonna go ahead and add an image. Now I'm gonna insert an image here and it's not gonna fill the entire screen, but I'm gonna go find a cooking image here. So I'm gonna search for cooking and let's go ahead and find something, just whatever looks good there. Now I'm gonna make this cause I'm gonna connect the two together. So I'm gonna make this background that same color blue here. Now to connect the two items together into a one page section, all I have to do is click on this connect button. Now when I go to this page or this section, it's gonna have both the image and the text in that one section. So let's go ahead and preview that. So there's my first page. I'm gonna go ahead and go move on. And there is my image and my text below on the same page or the same section basically. Now there's a couple other things that you can do. I'm gonna go back into edit here and I'm gonna go back into themes here and we're gonna go into navigation. Now you could have this stepped navigation where it takes you step by step into the different blocks. And you can also change the indicators from dots to numbers if you wanted to, or you could just get rid of that if you don't want that indicator. I'm gonna switch it back to dots. I really do like the dots. Or I can change this to continuous. Now continuous, let me save that and go back in here. Now continuous is pretty much the same thing as what other Rise courses are. It's just one long scrolling page. So once you hit next, every section is just a block basically. But it's not several pages, it's just one page. Again, this is micro learning, so you're focused on as simple content as possible to deliver, and that's really what this feature is all about. So you can either do the continuous or you can do the steps. Either way, it allows you to adjust those. Now, everything else inside of here, as far as what I can tell, is pretty much the same. So you can still export to SCORM, you can export to web, you can export to CMI5, you can share it with other people, you can post it to a review as well. All of that is the same as your regular RISE courses. So I just wanted to call that out, spend a little time with the new micro learning feature inside of RISE and explore that a little bit and make sure that you explored all the different parts of it. I think it's a really cool feature. Allows you to create simple courses. And I love the step-by-step section there where you focus just on certain parts of the content and each of those different steps. So hopefully this was useful for you. If you wanted to check out more, go to my YouTube channel, learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering everything learning development. You can also check out templates and download free templates for Articulate Storyline 360, XAPI templates as well, and then full courses, everything from A to Z on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate RISE, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. And if you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button and subscribe to my channel, and also hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to keep creating these videos for you. And if you have any other questions, you can also add a comment down below. What else do you want to see with RISE, with any type of learning developments? I am always searching for different topics and things that I could do to help the community. So let me know down below of what you would want to see. But that's all that I have for you today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.